Operations report. Repairs complete. Sightings. 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 Supplies moved. Repairs complete. Expansions. Replacements taken and Warspite begins refit. Ah! Upgrades, right? Devices at Ponape. Some Russian ones, Soviet ones. And the this one's one to take notice. The 303rd Brigade at Hankow. We'll take a look at that. Ponape. That the one I want to see upgraded, the 19th Indian Division, isn't here! Damn it! Repairs complete. Upgrade. Replacements taken. Ah, the Chinese upgrade. But not the Indians. Reinforcements, Alameda and Portland. Okay, the first thing we're going to take a look at right away is that over on 303rd Brigade. Now, this 303rd Brigade, I had planned on using it as a garrison unit. When using a garrison unit, why bother upgrading? Well, I don't need the top level. I can use some old piece of crap that as long as it has assault value, it fulfills the requirement of garrison. So this is another screw up on my part. You got to keep, is this number 4,820? Yeah, something like that. Screw up on sloppiness on my part. What I had told it, what I said was upgrade. I allowed the upgrade to go through. All I wanted was replacements. Now I'm wasting good top of the line infantry, the latest infantry, on a garrison unit sitting in the backwater somewhere. A whole lot of nothing. Oh, what a stupid ass I am. I know. Yeah, I know. Everyone agrees. So I'm going to be real careful. I'm not going to waste too many of these top-notch infantry squads. I'll let it build up just up to the level of required for the garrison, and then I'll stop. But I don't want to waste any other units like this, so I'm going to make sure I use the hotkey G, call up all the ground units for Chinese. Let's take a look at the infantry units for the Chinese. Let's make sure nobody else is dumb enough to here's the U upgrade, sort by upgrades. This is a very nice filter. Really, really, really nice. Now we can see all the units that are supposed to upgrade. And there's not many acts that were set for the Chinese. The Chinese, the cavalry was set. This is a unit that was broken up into three components. I'm going to turn off the upgrade for the cavalry. Don't need it. They're also acting as a garrison unit. So why use your top-notch squads for guard duty? These reserve divisions are in Thailand, and you know what? I'm going to let them upgrade. Why? Because these divisions can be purchased. One of the few divisions or one of the few units in the Chinese army that I can actually purchase and send offshore. So if and when I decide to invade Japan, I can take these Chinese units along with me, and that could be a pretty significant chunk of firepower, manpower. So I want these guys upgrade, sure thing. Let them upgrade. Let them get the best squads possible. Any other upgrades? Nope. All the other ones. See, notice that? That's a nice ability to filter according to the upgrade status. So all the other ones are not going to upgrade. Right. We're now in China. We have, oh, wonderful. These guys are dock, replenished. The narwhal is back. We're unloading. Oh, we'll also disband after unloading. We'll just repair that one point of damage first. Are the submarines nothing ready to go here? Anything ready to go in Shanghai? Ah, one's ready to go. Sailfish. Good. What's the what? Which patrol zone shall we send sailfish? Oh, there's a good number out here. Whoa! There's a carrier here. Wow, that settles it. Send it sailfish into the carrier zone. She'll probably be gone by the time we get out there. That's all right. That's all right. Pakoi's really been taking it on the chin. He's wearing down our fighters. So we're gonna have to pull these out, get in some fresh squadron or fresh flights of P-40 kilos. These guys just aren't doing the job. What the hell? They're getting killed! And they're not bad pilots. There's a couple of newer ones, but they're not totally bad pilots, so I'll make sure I get some top-notch pilots in here. I might have to... Where is it here? No, where's the base? Ah, base force. Now that I've got another base force in Nanning, I might fly a second squadron up here and try to be mutually protective of each other. At least we'll have some more aviation support. Down here we have about 60 aviation support, so we can get a few more down. We can get another squadron in here. In the confrontation, my units aren't doing too badly. Recovering, but no, there's no rush. What did we start off with? I think it was 3,400. I think we'll wait until we get close to 3,400 again before we launch another attack. Still stuck at Langson. Okay, we jumped the fighters waiting at Tuyun over to Paoshan, the fighters at Paoshan over to Lido. And now the fighters at Lido, we're down to 1 and 2 fatigue. That's close enough. Rebuild. We're going to take all 36 of them. Let's transfer as far as we can. I think it's Chongqing. Now that we're here, we'll divide and recover. Lido has room to take aviation acquired 13. So we can take another 19. But we're going to take, these guys are fatigue level 5. We'll divide and then transfer over. Transfer Lido so that we can maximize the number of fighters to grab. There we go. So we can have 4 with each group. Overloads Lido a little bit. Yeah, just a little bit. But next turn we'll hopefully be able to fly these units out of here. We put another squadron down into Pakoi. But these guys, yeah, these are about half strength. They got bashed up pretty badly last turn. We flew one all the way back from Lido to reinforce. So what is that? 10, 26 fighters here? Hopefully that'll be enough. But because we're trying to cover such a large area, we're trying to cover Nanning at the same time. That's probably hurting us, not getting enough fighters in the air. In Chongqing, we finally are able to add a few more reserves. Oh, we've used them all up. So now to transfer them back to Changsha. We'll go to escort. That's it. All the I-15s are now used up. Now that Changsha has a modicum of air cover. Oh, why are we flying both of them at night? These guys will fly during the day. The only one that can really hit it are Bettys. And the Bettys against biplanes, at least we don't have to worry about enemy fighters. Okay, so the I-15s will cover Changsha. I'm going to move these Hawk 81s. I'm going to ship them over to Canton. We're going to fly them at night. The ones at Canton. We've got our bow fighters flying at night. They're a little slight fatigue on them. So I'm going to order them to rest. Sweep, rest. We can transfer all the way up, I think, to Lido. Can't we? Yeah, we could go straight to Lido from here if we want. Once they recover a little bit, I'll send them to Lido so that we can maximize the number of reserve. There's 40 some odd fighters out there. Replacement, so I might as well take advantage and bring some of them over. So the Hawk 81s will fill in while the bow fighters are away. Out here in northern China, we're seeing some odd things. We hit the W key to see the ownership of some hexes and see that there's no. See, this red line here indicates that I own the hex, except somebody must have penetrated it to get in here, even though my unit doesn't detect them. I'm going to check to see if there's one thing we can do is, yes, if there's an enemy in the hex, I cannot use the rest mode. So obviously there is an enemy in the hex. My assault value is 86, so I'm just going to, do a deliberate attack, but no. We're just going to wait for the enemy, let him do the attacking. The terrain is rough, so we have double defensive effects modifier. Instead, now that the enemies come in through here, that was the one that came out of Chaifeng, came down and through here. I've got a unit up here, 7th Group Army. I've got this Chinese Corps. I'm going to rush it, change direction. I'm going to come in here. I'm going to try to seal this sucker in and kill it. We got bombed, damn it, and lost a couple of squads on here, damn it. We got a little too far away, but I gotta rush him. There's also this, I'm gonna use this headquarters unit to do the same. As long as one of them gets down here, we can seal it in. If the enemy's too strong, he might be able to destroy my dispersed unit, my component. It's only one third of a core here. Here's another third coming down behind it. So I'm hoping that I can trap them. If I can trap them behind, we'll do the same thing as we've done here and as we're doing here. We'll starve them to death and then annihilate them. Another thing happened. Oh, look at this one. Look, here in this hex, I've got a couple of headquarters squads. One's moving to this hex. So I'm going to order it. It's 1 mile away. It's just 1 mile out. So I'm going to order it into reserve mode, hopefully. So it should be able to cross the river. Even if we're attacked, I'm hoping that this headquarters will bear the brunt of it. Now, I don't have any assault value in this one. These are just unarmed headquarters units. So I'm going to try to get a unit in. He's come out of Jihol, and he's, notice the red there? Maybe you can't see it, but it's the same thing. Green all the way around, all hex sides, except this one right here, which is red. So the enemy has come out of that city to challenge me. Does that mean that the city is open? I don't know. I'm going to try to move into it. These are unarmed headquarters squads. Now, I think there was a change in the game that one is moving to the northeast. Okay. I'm going to change the direction of the other one to try to move in here. See if we can't seal it up. Now, in Admiral's edition, no, it used to be that I could still advance into an enemy hex with an unarmed unit. But I don't know if it was a recent, how recent the change was. I think they changed it so that if I don't have assault value and there's an enemy unit in the hex, I will not be allowed to enter the hex. So what? Not there's. I guess is looking at these. Well, it see normally it would say there would say enemy, right? If we're moving towards an enemy, let's see this one. No, it doesn't say that. But if you're moving toward here you go. We're moving towards an enemy. So we're moving southwest into an enemy hex. If there was an enemy here, this one should be showing me that message, enemy. But it isn't. So, oh, okay, look at all these, there is no red lines around it. So it looks as though the hex is not owned by the enemy. He's abandoned it. I'm quite happy. If I can get in here, if as long as I sit over here and survive the first barrage, the enemy will be cut off from supply. So we got to get in here quickly, as quick as possible. These guys will, you need to survive two. Assaults, I guess, would be a good description. Now, oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. You know, this unit it on the move, this unit in reserve is heading for 9839. This is this 98? No, 9839. So it was going to move here and then up. But because the enemy has already accommodated and moved in on us, I'm going to cancel this movement. Cancel the move. Well, yeah, I know. I'm giving up a whole hell of a lot. I know I am. I know. But this doubles the number of, well, not doubles, but it increases the number of infantry squads on here. So if the enemy attacks, hopefully he will dilute his attack against both units. He might damage, he might even destroy a few squads, hurt us a little bit, but if he's a weak unit, he won't be able to destroy us before we seal him in behind. And once we seal it in behind, that's what happened up here. All we had was two headquarters units. But we held on long enough to get to ram an infantry unit in behind it and destroy the enemy. And I'm hoping for the same here. Survive long enough, cut him off, then we can destroy the enemy. Unfortunately, up at Calgan, we didn't have enough air cover. They managed to bomb and destroy a squad over on this 81st Chinese Corps. So we intercepted. We got some, but not enough. There's just not enough fighters up here. Let me see if I can find another fighter squadron to bring over. Okay, I found some fighters. I don't know if they'll have the range to get out here. Chungking, we had a squadron of vanguards. They're here trying to pick up some additional fighters for reserve, but we are delayed by 3 days. We aren't going to be able to take replacements for 3 days, so I'm going to try to fly them out to, where is that place? No, none of these guys. What's the name of that place? Out to Calgan. Let's see, from here to Calgan is 23. No, that's too far away. From here to Baoding is 20. Is that close enough? No, it isn't. Oh, so I can't even leapfrog forward. All right, Galgan has enough aviation support, so I'm just gonna jump these guys forward. Mohawks. We're gonna double up. Transfer up to Galgan. So Kalgan will have extra fighters. We don't need two of them flying at night. So we're gonna change this one to day. Oh, what's the range? These guys are flying at 50% at 5. Okay, we'll do the same thing. Keep the stress level down. Oh boy, we better fly at least 10,000 altitude, I think. There. I'm going to bring these fighters out of Chungking. We're still going to leave them. I think Kaifeng is a good place for them. Yep, Kaifeng has aviation support. So I'm going to transfer to Kaifeng. We'll just divide and rest. Next turn, we'll make the leap. Here is another squadron of Mohawks ready, but we've just come in from Lido, so they're a little bit tired, and there's some damaged ones, so we need to recover those. Oh, crap. Oh, can you believe that? We just got in, and we crashed one already! Urgh! That's not good. Rebuild, divide. How's that? Yeah, I think we crashed one. No, me. Oh no, there it is. There it is. So each one should have 12, but somehow this one has 13 fighters. Who knows? Who knows? So next turn, depending on if the enemy attacks over here, we've got Kalgan, and he's flying around in a range of 5, so he should be able to cover all this whole area sufficiently. If there's a leaker, if someone starts attacking near Pouting, we can bring in these vanguards next turn. Two Chinese corps, the 84th and the 10th, arrived late here. So the other ones are already assigned for Peiping or Tianjin. These guys are going to start, the extra two corps are going to start marching for the woods, hoping to relieve the headquarters guys. As long as they can survive, we can get in there to crush the enemy. So guys, hold on, hold on, hold on. Help is coming. In the north, we got headquarters unit moving around to the flank. I'm trying to move it up here and then approach from two different sides at the same time into these hexes to try to cut off the enemy from retreat to the north. Thailand. We've conducted reconnaissance over Siratani and it's 9 out of 10. There's nothing here. So how the freak can the AI just grab bases back without any units on there? You cheating, no good son of a bugger. Doesn't even make the pretense of trying to capture the base. All right. The Mitchells, we've flown the mission. We're tired. We only have a two fatigue, so I'm gonna fly another one. Let's see about Vinh. If it's open, we will attack it on the way back with the submarines. Ayutthaya, this is the, what do you call it? The assembly area. We now have just under 14,000, well, under 14,000 in supplies, but now the requirement's gone up to 20,000, so we're still up the creek. Well, still trying to gather these units that have just arrived. Okay, so we'll put them together. Gosh, another 2 days to unpack and then another day to move out here. What a pain. 3 days to unpack. Holy crap. So we're probably not going to be able to start the attack for another week. Problem is, some of my units are going to disappear within a month or two. So that's not good. The cavalry regiment. And another cavalry. See, like 147 days. Some of them are going to be gone by the end of the month, I think. 50. Let's see. Okay, these guys are... We're just going to leave these guys here. Right. I think it's one of the armor. Yeah, the 7th armored is gone in 3 months. So we need to burn them up, use them up, or else they're gone from us. What else is gone at the end of them? 55 days. See, this one's not even going to last 55 days. So I've turned off the replacements. The 7th armored, 86 days. Yeah, I think I'll turn off the replacements here too. Because these guys can sure use them. Here's that 19th division. Still not upgrading. All right. Chiang Mai. Oh, these guys are still coming. Still can't get any supplies on Phitsanulok. My cavalry unit is starting to move to the northeast. Trying to move around. Try to get. I know there was one unit here. We detected a unit here. I don't think it's moved away yet. We'll try to get around and into Ubon. We continue to cycle the Mohawk fighters and others from Rangoon and Pegu up to Akyab in order to get some replacements, because there's not enough supplies down here to allow for replacements. We need 20,000, I believe, and Akyab has that. Has sufficient supplies for that. No enemy sighted near Salnan. No enemy sighted near Bombay. No enemy sighted in anywhere in the Arabian Sea. So we'll just do our usual convoys in and out. One convoy inbound, one convoy outbound. We exchange escorts. Oh, Maria. Okay. The transport here, let's see. Didn't we just send one over? Yes, we did. We'll check the dates on these guys. Oh, we can't see. Okay, here. 28 days, 28 days, 28 days to the East Coast. So 28 days out and 28 days back. 56, one day to load. 57. It's 57 days, and the resupply convoy is coming in 52 days. Coming to Cape Town. 52 days plus 3 days before it dissolves, so it's 55. It's almost all perfect, right? So, I'm not losing anything by sending ships all the way out to the United States in order to bring back supplies. I won't even bother with this. There's only one little ship here, Morelia. Heck. We'll form, transport. Oh, is there? No. We've already picked up the brigade, so there's no ground unit to pick up. Let's just load supplies and then just sit and wait for the next convoy to form. Submarine check. Nobody damaged. Okay. Argonaut. We heading to China for naval commandos. Narwhal sitting here unloading, and Nautilus about to make an approach for Koshikijima. Torpedoes check. S-39 has engaged several times. Oops. One torpedo left. Time to come home. Nicely done, sir. Well, several torpedo engagements, but all except for one is returning. Still has torpedoes to remain on station. The one boat, the S boat, S-39, is the only one returning back. Over in Darwin, only the enemy bombed the hell out of Alor, destroyed the garrisons. So now we just have to replace it. The enemy is seen at Saumlaki. We sank a few, we bombed a few ships here. Don't know if we actually sank any, but, we did get some hits. So, but he still has a garrison here. So nothing else happening in the Timor Sea. Who's this? A fast-moving transport. Where the hell is he going? AKE and a fast transport. And us without any bombers here, okay? I'll move the hell divers over to Kavieng. Oh, come on. I need drop tanks to get over there? Oh, you stupid bastard. Yeah. Well, we'll see if we can't hit anything from out here. It's a range of 8. Oh, crap. Jeez, you guys are terrible. Fine, we'll go with drop tanks. When we're on search, they increase the range, but they also increase the fatigue level. We had one Dauntless squadron over here. I'm going to move this one over to Kavieng. Can we get over to Kavieng? Nope. We have no drop tanks either. Okay, let's see how far we can transfer over to Port Moresby. Alright. Rest. And then we'll head over to Kavieng if necessary. The Mitchells are still here, but they didn't launch. So is he going to try another one of those BS invasions? Does look like it, doesn't it? An APD here. So where the hell's he going to land? Crap. Well, we can always send the cruisers back out after him. Here comes the carrier. The ships, I'm going to send an escort out for her. We'll send a proper escort. Cruiser. And destroyers. Merge. While they're out, we're going to form transport. All the AKs that just came back. Yes, click 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 click. Yes. Click like a maniac, I know. Wow, lots of room to dock even. Here's one that's already filled up. We'll undock this one. So we can add a few more here. AK, right. Let's take the big ones first. Actually, we're going to take all of them probably. Wow, just load up everybody. Okay, load supplies. That's 86,000 plus another 25,000. That's 100,000 in supplies. Here, that's 100,000 plus another 100,000. So that's 200,000 that we can move over to Darwin. 200,000 puts that at 360,000. Okay, I'll probably do it twice, put it up over 500,000, and then we'll go do the invasions of Saipan. At Brisbane, convoy's heading back. Convoy heading in. Our two cripples haven't gotten worse. Uh-oh. Did they get worse? Oh, no, no, he actually managed to pump it clear. I think it would have... 73, I think it had gone up to 75 and dropped back down to 73. So they managed to conduct some repairs on the way through as they were traveling. That's great. Three convoys headed for Suva. Nothing at Suva. Convoys heading across. Convoys heading down. Nothing happening in Panama. Nothing happening in Pearl Harbor. Carrier coming back. We have the three AOs docking and unloading. Actually, why don't we just... I'm going to set their home base for San Francisco. Okay, when you're finished unloading, just go sail straight for San Francisco. All right, here. And here. Did that work? Yes, that works. That's correct. San Francisco, Alameda. There's, oh, four transports. Wow. Form transport. Okay. Return to San Francisco. Four new ships. At San Francisco, we have two ships, two transports. These guys are full. These are the APs. This is the Pearl Harbor run. And these guys are, they're full enough. I say these guys go to Brisbane, and the other ones go to Pearl Harbor. This is pure supply. Since we'll be moving a lot of half a million or quarter of a million supply points over to Darwin, we better bring some more down there. 2312. What the hell? Ah, wrong. Wrong island. Okay, wrong waypoint. Let's see. First waypoint was... Oops, it's right here. 1, 2, 3. There you go. Cancel, unlock. It's only 50,000, but every 50,000 helps. This one's for Pearl Harbor. Undock. Okay, that should be it. Check the ships for any auxiliaries, any AOs. Ah, there is an AO. Okay, we'll load tender. But she's still damaged. And tanker. First off, any ships due for upgrade? No, none. Form transport. Take the tankers first. There's an AO here that just... It obviously didn't get fully repaired last turn. Should I... I think I'm just going to repair... I just think I'll, one point, I'm not going to be anal about it. Dock. Load supplies. Let's see. Any AKs around? No auxiliaries. Oh, all these AKs are actually in good shape. Okay. I'm also going to load the LSTs. There's a couple of landing ships. We're just going to load them and sail them, even though they're a little bit slower. There are three of them now, so I'm going to need every landing vessel I can get over at Ponape. Are there any more APs? Oh, we still have lots of APs we can load. Okay, there's another Pearl Harbor run. Dock, transfer. Oh, God. No, no. There we go. Wow. Jammed full. Okay. Load supplies. It's good that to see that once if we're free of the darned escort requirement, we can just keep sending them and sending them and sending them. So not a lot of hassle. Operational report. Any reinforcements? Ah, Alameda, we caught those. Portland. Okay. Portland. Form. Set. San Francisco. Auto disband. Take the coastal route. Anything out in Pearl Harbor? Nope. Okay, we're over on Ponape. Ponape. Okay, at Ponape, I've reorganized all the ships into one docked unloading, another one undocked unloading, and the third one, these are the empties. I think I'm going to send them back to San Francisco. No need. I'm going to leave the ones. I don't think we're going to go down to pick up in Suva, just because there's three convoys coming through already. It's only CBs left over, lots of CBs. If we have to go back and forth a couple of times, fine, it's just CB battalions. They're not really big divisions. Plus, I can use the assault transports to retrieve them rather than using these commercials. The XAKs, I'll use them to go back to the States and get more supplies. Ponape now has three quarters of a million supplies, which is great. But fuel is only at 50,000. That's maybe two task forces full. Two combat task forces would easily drain that. That enemy submarine that was found lurking north of Bikini, I lost it. Lost track of it. That's not a good thing. Where the hell did it go? No idea. I might be getting a flaming datum. First indication of submarine is a ship sinking. Wasp is now close enough to Pearl Harbor. We're going to try to sort out all the squadrons, send them back to their original carriers. The squadrons have returned to their original carriers, mostly. Wasp is picking up an extra Marine squadron so that we can get a carrier qualified. Plus, we need the extra fighters on here. S-33 slams a torpedo into a transport in the gauntlet. S-37 hits a mine layer in Strait of Malacca. Night attack on Amoy. Lancers are up. One Betty damaged. Air attack Changsha, as predicted. The Bettys come through. Three are destroyed. The second I leave, I move the Lancers over to Canton. Or is it the Van? I move the Vanguard out of here. The Bettys sense that their weakness, so they attack. Changsha bombed again. Three more Bettys destroyed. Akyab bombing class. Majiro bombing practice. Air attack Pakoi. 20 Warhawks are up against 5 Nyx. We get 1. Wow. 20 to 5. 4 to 1 and we get 1. Those guys are tough. Pakoi bombed again. 19 Warhawks are up. But we only get 1-0. Jaliwit bombing practice. Air attack Tolun. Damn it. Damn it. We intercept. There's just not enough. There's just not enough. Maybe okay, it's only 3 away. Maybe the range is too great. Maybe I should change it down to 3 or 4. That would concentrate the fighters a little bit more. The reconnaissance regiment bombed at Prachup Kirikan, another unit disabled. The garrison force over on Lomblin bombed into destruction, bombed pieces. That must be the aerial recon conducted over Vin. Detection level 6 out of 6 now. Okay. Not perfect, but we're going to have to fly that mission again. Bombardment near Jehol. Yep, looks like the enemy brought a infantry brigade. That's about 50 assault value. That's great. If all he wants to do is bombard, have at it, buddy. Bombardment near Jehol. Oh, another cavalry brigade. How much are those things? I think it's probably another 50 assault value. So we outnumber them. We have greater firepower, I think.